Same question, but in a different way. Many people believe that Hindu or Hinduism is a great way to live life because we have a lot of gods, still we are one. But when they hear any Vaishnava or when they attend any program from ISKCON, and when they hear that there's only one Supreme Lord, somehow they don't, you know, take it, you know, I don't know what they are saying about. And also they believe that it is a very, very good way to live life because there is a unity in diversity.
Mm-hmm.
And when we say there is only one Supreme Lord, it somehow defeats that theory and somehow make it, you know, a bit tough for people to understand there is one Supreme Lord, or they should believe that there is only one Supreme Lord. Mm-hmm. Like I said, that they grew up, you know, worshipping different Lords, like Lord Shiva, Lord Ganesha. So how would you address those kinds of, you know...
I guess you have already addressed it, Aman Prabhu. He already mentioned it. We have different gods, and ISKCON, when they come, or any Vaishnavas, they come, they say that there is one Supreme Lord. So you are saying the same.
Yeah.
There are, yes, there are different demigods, but there is one Supreme Lord. And this unity in diversity, it will still happen. Like we have, I'll give you example of government again. We have our government.
Yeah.
And in the government, there is one on the head. And then there are cabinet ministers and the people under them, and the whole bureaucrat system is there, bureaucracy system is there, and you all are also there in that. In the similar way, we are saying that if you elect some prime minister, then it will kill unity in diversity?
No.
Our elections are happening so that there is establishment of unity in diversity. But we also know that there is one person who is heading the whole government. In a similar way, Lord Krishna is heading it.
Okay.
And then, but we are not negating anybody's position. We are not negating. We respect them a lot.
Yeah.
And we also say, yes, we have to carry them.
Yeah. So on the same point, like, because many other religions like Christianity and, you know, Islam, they believe in only one God or in just one messenger of God.
Hmm.
And that is how, you know, Hindus take
pride
in that.
Huh.
Or they believe, okay, we are somehow we are different from any other religion.
Huh.
And but like I said, that now when you say, no, we are just following one God, like when you go to any temple of ISKCON, there's only one God, only one Lord.
Huh.
So they don't feel that comfortable, or they somehow make it, you know, feel, or they are somehow a bit different than other people.
Huh.
So basically, my point is that, you know, how we can, you know, address those kind of people and make them believe that there is nothing bad in believing one Supreme Lord while worshipping different gods.
Hmm.
So how we can address those kind of people?
Okay. I want to begin by saying that we don't want anybody to, or we don't want to force on anybody that you believe what I'm saying. You have your intelligence and you have your developed consciousness. You know which path should be taken by you. You can decide. But we only request one thing. Explore.
Explore. Correct.
You must explore. And the point which you mentioned, after exploring into Christianity and Islam, and say we feel pride being Hindus. We feel pride that we have many gods and we are unity in diversity. I'll say, coming back to the point of religion, the purpose of religion is to love and serve the Supreme Lord. Okay. It is not to establish that there is one God or many God. Any religion, their purpose is only to teach how to love God, how to serve Him, and within the boundary of that, how to serve every individual, every other living entity.
Right.
Like Lord Jesus, the very prominent messenger, He is and Son of God, He has mentioned, "Thou shalt not kill." And how that has come? That has come in the point, or we should respect our neighbors as we respect our own self. So how these 10 commandments are been propagated? This is only on the basis that we love the Supreme and we serve the Supreme, and everyone is part and parcel of Him. It is His creation. So we have to love and serve our neighbor also. We have to love and serve every other living entity, even the animals, birds, trees, plants, everyone. We should respect them. So, but I'm coming to your point of one God or many gods and unity in diversity. even in Islam or Christianity, they propagate this. And even in Sanatan Dharma or Hinduism, we have clear understanding that there is one God. Now, the person who has, by birth, he was worshipper of Lord Shiva or Mother Durga or Kali or Ganesha or Kartikeya or anybody, even Hanumanji, we are not saying that, you know, stop worshipping them or stop respecting them. No, we are not saying that. We are saying, what are the roots? With your proper understanding, what are the roots?
Yeah.
And what is the root? Krishna explains in Bhagavad Gita that he is root of the entire universe.